automated, the connecting pieces and so on. But it's not a real simulation.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's move on in the program. The next point on the agenda reads time of flight chopper spectrometers. I'll give you a few slides and then we'll do it's listed as an exercise in the program. We will do that as well. Just talk a bit about these time of flight spectrometers. We'll focus on the direct geometry kind for this time. So just a reminder here, what are we talking about? There's elastic and inelastic scattering, but you already know everything about all there is to know about inelastic scattering or something like that. So there are two kinds of spectrometers in this case. There's the direct geometry one, where you follow a wavelength as time goes along the distance of the instrument, and at some point there's a monochromatic device, so you might have lots and lots of wavelengths here, but not from here, and then at the sample position, which is slightly afterwards, you may have some inelastic scattering, and then the timing on the detector will actually give you an energy resolution. In terms of an inverse geometry thing, you would have a white beam hitting the sample, and then you would have a monochromating device afterwards, several monochromating devices afterwards, so you can keep a certain amount. But we'll focus on the left-hand one, from your side point of view, for now. Just some useful links. You've already seen them before, I suppose. The important point here is this last one, which we will show a look at. You've all seen MC display by now, where you can visually trace your neutrons through your instrument. There is a variant of this where you can generate time of flight diagrams, like much like this one. I'll show you how to do that. This is something taken from one of the websites. We have a couple of versions of this. There's mcdisplay.pl, that's the Perl PQPlot version, and there's the mcdisplay.pyqpgraph, can also do that. If you specify any of these command line options, so you can, and then if you use that, you can get these kinds of diagrams directly, where the green lines are the neutrons, and in this case there's a chopper here, so only a certain type of neutron with the right wavelength, i.e. the right slope here, can get through the chopper and make it to some point here, and up here there is monitor ND, and here is something is detected. Now in the Python based versions of the tool, this will be something like this. Let's see if I can go over the function control meta.
Control all meta 8.
So that's the way. So you can see that most of these starting lines are stopped in this chopper here. Here in the dipole, or all the dipoles. That's ion 15. So this is a schematic of the first one, the ion 4. It has a bunch of choppers for background, and then it has a, actually has a curved monochromator, which you may be able to see some interesting stuff going on in the resolution spectrum, or in the loop resolution function of this of this instrument. Where particularly when it comes, it's combined with a Fermi chopper. And then you get a sample, and there's a collimator, a radial collimator here, and then almost a bunch of detectors going on up here. And you might notice that you also get detectors going the other way, get smaller as well. Some more talk details about this instrument. High flux, high flux spectrometer. It's rather close to the source. So let's do some work. We will simply start with the ILL ion 4 instrument that you can already get from that is included in your McStas distribution. We will try to visualize this instrument first and look at some code. Go on with it. And we can actually generate an SQ omega with the Dirac delta functions by Pelgrin's is something a feature that's included in the instrument. And that's useful to actually look at the resolution function of this, as you know, if you use a Dirac delta, then you automatically follow the get up the resolution function of the instrument by looking at this spread. And so this we will do. To illustrate the resolution function of this instrument and so on. And then we will investigate what happens when we change the wavelength. Does it change the resolution function and so on? We could even play with monitoring stability. This is all on the website or in the GitHub, so we will be working from there. I'll just go through it so you know what it is we think you should be doing. And then we will look at the ion 5. Looks similar at least, except that it doesn't have this strange monochromator. It's more or less the same idea, that the monochromatic beam enters the sample, and then it's just a different beam. And we will do the more or less the same thing. We can do the same thing as in ion 4 by adding this parameter, and then we can look at the resolution function for this. So this exercise is all about looking at the resolution function, which can be quite complicated for these times.